Yes, we're on Easy. So tell us your name and a little bit about you and how you came through.
As to my name is Ezeonwa Adike. I'm originally Nigeria. I started up in Montgomery College and later get a full scholarship transfer to Alabama State University. I studied health information management, and it's a very great and exciting field. I've done a lot of couple of things. I work in CDC and things like that. But I'm just trying to share a little bit story for young people out there. You know, everybody these days they see me. Everybody get a handshake. You know, but they don't know how it started. It took a lot of time. So like before I graduated from school, it was really really hard because I'm an international student and it's a lot of struggle when you're an international student in this country. But you know, but the most important news I have for international student or someone from other countries that are out there is like hard work always pays off. You know, you have to do your own part, just allow all the obstacle that is around you, because I believe that we don't have any other obstacles around us. The only obstacle we have is the one you made for yourself or the one you allow others to make for you.
So that actually works for anybody. There are people who are even from this country who when they run into an obstacle, they give up. They feel in the struggle.
Yeah, so I mean that gonna bring me to sharing this a little bit story, like how I landed myself to where I am right now. Before I graduated from school, I started applying for jobs like about 6 months before I graduated, because I'm a kind of person, I already set up my goal, I know what to do, I prepare myself before the actual thing happens,
yes,
so that I can have options and things like that to get through it. So I applied to so many jobs. I applied to, let me say, a million jobs. And like in a day, I set a goal. Like sometimes I apply to 1,000 jobs. I have interviewed with so many companies. I've interviewed with CGI. I've interviewed with Accenture. I've interviewed with Goldman Sachs in New York. And you know, the only issues that I always have is like they don't want to get me in because I'm not a resident. But I didn't give up. You know, most of my friends, they gave up. Some of them went back to their home country, until one day I kept applying. Zen Network called me for interview. So when I went to Zen, after the interview, they called me the same day and they told me that they want to offer me the job.
And now, there were many other people, I'm sure, that they interviewed.
Yeah. After working with Zen for like 2 months, I asked my boss, why did he choose me? He said that that I'm not even close to the kind of people he interviewed in terms of experience. But he see that I'm that person that he can call on the phone by 2 o'clock in the morning, early in the morning I will pick up. He sees me as that kind of person that I won't sleep until the work gets done. He sees me as that kind of person that will take this project as my own personal life. So that was why he offered me the job. And most of my friends, they started good, you know, but I was really surprised. Like, you know, I started with 35 an hour just out from school. I mean, that's so exciting and, you know, a very great opportunity for me. So, you know.
We're going to continue this again. I'm going to pause this. But this is, again, our good friend Easy, we call him for short, did magnificent things. Stay tuned for the next part.